Hello, welcome to the second session of using VBA in PowerPoint 2013 from the ground up. In this session, we are going to look into the VBA editor, which is also called IDE, which is Integrated Development Environment. We'll also take a look into the developer tab and write a few starting scripts. We'll try to see how these scripts can be assigned to different buttons. And we'll also see something called the kiosk mode, how the kiosk mode is used to control the navigation of presentations from one slide to another, right? Okay. So to go to the VBA editor, you have to press Alt F11 from the design view of PowerPoint. When you open the editor, you will have this project window here. And if you don't have it, you can go to view, you can click on this project explorer or press Ctrl R and you'll get this window here. Then you go to view again, click on properties window or press F4, you will get the properties window here again. Now to add coding or to write code, we need the code window. So when you click on this project here, right click on it, say insert, and go to module. So a new module will be added to your project as module 1, and you will get this new place or the new window that opens up. It's called the code window. This is where we are going to write our code. Okay, so one other way of opening the VBA editor is to go to the developer tab here and click on Visual Basic. That will also take you to the IDE or the Integrated Development Environment, right? Now if you have checked the previous series, there we have talked about how to enable this developer tab, right? If you have not checked that video, you can go to the description below. I've put a link to that video. Okay, alright, so let's go to the VBA editor again and write our first code. So press Alt F11. Now to start writing a code in VBA editor, you have to type sub my first code and press enter. Writing sub says that we are going to start a new subroutine, and it automatically puts these two brackets here, and it also writes end sub at the end. This says that the subroutine ends here, right? So what is a subroutine and how it works, and what is this function and how it is different from a subroutine? We'll see all these things in the next videos. So here we are going to write our first script and see how it works. Okay. So let's write a simple code saying message box. It will show a message box here. So it is asking for a prompt. Let's say hello world. So this is what we are going to see. We'll put a comma. Then it's asking me for the button type. So you will select a button type called information, VB information. Then we'll say comma again, and it's asking me for the title. So let's see my first code message box. Okay, all right, let's see what happens in this when you run. So if you look into this editor here, we have an option to run the subroutine or the user form. So here we are going to run the subroutine. So you can either press F5 or you can click on this button here. So let's click on this button and see what happens. So it gives a message box saying hello world, and it has a title, my first code, and the button type is VV information. Based on the button type what you select, you will get the icon here. Okay, so let's say okay. So this is our first script that we have just written. Now, for all those who have not seen our previous videos, the first introductory series, I request you all to go and check those videos, because there you will get to know a couple of things that can be done using VBA, right? So if you go through those sample videos, it will be easy for you to start off with coding. You'll also know that you can do a lot of things using VBA in PowerPoint 2013. So we have three sample projects in our previous introductory series. One is about slide navigation, the other one talks about login screen, and the third one talks about countdown timer. So if you can go through those, you will have an idea of how VBA in PowerPoint 2013 works. Okay, so I'd recommend you to please go to these three videos and take a look at them. So let's move into control navigation. Here we are going to see how you can control how the presentation moves, right? So when I say control navigation, we're mainly talking about how you go from one slide to the other. In presentation mode, you know that you can go to the next slide with a mouse click using the space bar, using the right arrow or the page down button. All this can take us to the next slide, right? If we just press the space bar, it takes us to the next slide, which is the landing page. But we want the user to move to the next slide only when we want him to, not when he presses any of these keys, right? So let's first stop the user to go to the next slide by using a mouse click or a space bar or a right arrow or page down button from the keyboard. To do that, we need to use the kiosk mode. To enable the kiosk mode, you need to go to slideshow, then go to setup slideshow, then use this option called browse that kiosk, right? Say okay. Now when you are in full screen mode, it will not let you go to the next slide even if you click or press a button on your keyboard, right? So how to move to the next slide from here when we are using the kiosk mode? One way of doing this is to insert a hyperlink. Let's say link to next slide, and we select the entire text and go to insert, then go to hyperlink. Then we select place in this document and we go to slide 5, which is my landing page, and say okay. Right. Now when you are in full screen mode, if you click on this hyperlink, it will take you to the next slide. But from this slide again, you cannot move anywhere. Okay. The other way of going to the next slide when you are in kiosk mode is to have a button which links to the next slide of your choice, right? So let's insert a button, go to shapes, you will select a button here, place the button here. It says hyperlink to next slide. By default, this is the selection that is there. So you click on OK. Now when you are in full screen mode, if you click on this button, it takes you to the landing page, right? You can go to any slide of your choice from within the kiosk mode, right? However, we can also do this using VBA. So let's see how we can use VBA to move to the next slide. So let's open the VBA editor. Let us insert a module. Let's write a new code for going to the next slide. So you say serve go to next. Okay. So the code that I'm going to write to go to the next slide is active presentation dot slideshow window dot view dot next. So this takes you to the next slide. Let's see how it works. So before that, we need to assign that code to a certain button or shape which we can click on when in the presentation mode, right? So now we'll see how to use a command button and write a code in it to go to the next slide, right? So to insert a command button, we have to go to developer and we'll select the command button under ActiveX control. Select the command button and paste it here, right? Now we have to assign a code to this command button so that it takes us to the next slide. To do that, double click on it and you will land into the code window. There you can write active presentation dot slideshow window dot view dot next, right? Let's see how it works. Now when we are in the full screen mode, you can click on this command button and it takes us to the next slide. Let's rename the command button here. Let's say next. Let's try to add a similar code and assign it to a shape. When you assign a code to a shape, the shape works as a command button, and next time when you click on that shape, it executes the macro that you have assigned to it, right? So to do so, let's create the macro first, then we'll add the shape. So we'll go to the VBA editor. Let's write the macro here again. Let's say sub go to next slide. Press enter. And since we are just going to the next slide, you can write exactly the same code. So we'll write active presentation dot slideshow window dot view dot next. This is one way of doing it. So now we'll assign this code to a button which will act as a command button, right? All right, so let's go to PowerPoint and insert a new shape. Let's use rounded rectangle here. Let's say next. Okay, so we have to assign the code now. To assign the code to this shape, you have to go to insert again and click on action. Here you have to select run macro and select the macro that you are going to use and say okay. Let's see what happens in the full screen mode. So now when we are in the full screen mode, We have already seen what happens when we click on this button. It takes us to the next slide. We have just added the code to this shape here. So let's click on it and see. It takes us to the next slide. So this is how you can write a simple code in the VB editor, in the code window in the VB editor. And you can subsequently add the assign the code to a shape or to a command button from the developer tab. right? So if you go to the control navigation video that we have created in the previous series, you will get a better view of the kiosk mode and how the code works in there, right? So that's all from us for this session. If you have any questions, if you have any suggestions for us, please feel free to use the description section below and we'll be happy to answer your queries. From the next session onwards, we are going to take a deep look into the VBA language and how to code with it in PowerPoint 2013. Right? Till then, take care, have fun, keep learning. Bye bye.